Hi everyone, in our today's session we are going to discuss the small signal operation of the transistor or BJT. Okay, so in our last session we have discussed different biasing techniques for the transistor. Now in that biasing we are going to see how small signal operation is going to be performed for the transistor to work as an amplifier. Okay, so for this we are going to consider common emitter configuration. So we know that common emitter configuration, the transistor to work as an amplifier, it should have to operate in an active mode. Okay, so to operate in an active mode, we should consider base emitter junction to be forward biased and base collector junction to be reverse biased. Now this is plus, this is minus. Okay, so now then only we can say that small signal operation is going to be performed, right? So small signal in the sense, in an DC biasing condition, we are going to introduce a very small signal which is going to get amplified. Okay, so that process we'll call it as a small signal getting superimposed with the DC biasing voltage. Now you just observe at the input side, I'm having an voltage capital V, capital B and capital E. Okay, so now before starting this, I want to clarify that if I am going to write the symbol in all in capital letters, it is called as DC biasing voltage or current. If I am going to write all the small letters, these are called as small signal voltages or current. So if I write the letter voltage or current in terms of small and the suffix as capital, it is called as instantaneous voltage or current. Likewise, I have what you can see, small I, capital V, small I, capital C, small I, capital E. These three are called as instantaneous current and this is called as instantaneous voltage. Okay. So now as I told, small signal is going to be superimposed on the DC biasing voltage. You can observe the base emitter voltage V, which is a DC supply. I am going to superimpose the small signal. The small signal you can observe, small VV. Okay. So now superimpose means I am going to get an instantaneous voltage, which is small v, capital VB is equals to VBE plus small VBE. So this is your DC biasing voltage, this is your small signal voltage. So this is called as instantaneous voltage. To get an instantaneous current IB, instantaneous current collector current, instantaneous emitter current IE. Okay. So now this is the current what you are going to obtain at the collector terminal, which are going to tell that it is an output. Now output is current, input is voltage, therefore this is operating in a transconductance mode. Transconductance mode, and amplifier is called as transconductance amplifier, right? So now therefore I am going to have IC by VB, IC by VB. What it is, we will observe. For this I am going to consider some relationship of the current and voltages in the DC biasing point. This is called as diode current voltage. Now you can see IC, capital IC is equal to IS into e to the power of capital VV by VT. So IE is equal to IC by alpha, IB is equal to IC by beta. I hope you know all these relationships. This I am going to use to analyze the effect that is going to be caused when I am superimposing a small signal voltage VBE. The effects are analyzed as different types of models. In our today's session, we are discussing the first model where we are going to see two things. One, amplification. Second one, whether it is a transconductance amplifier or not. Now, in the first model, we are going to see that we are going to study collector, that is small signal collector current and its transconductance. What it is going to be obtained, we are going to see. Now, for this, I am going to make use of this diode equation. IC is equal to IS into e to the power of VB by VT. I am going to write that in terms of instantaneous collector current, small I, capital C. Just remember, this gets confusion whether it is small c or capital C. It is small I, capital C makes instantaneous collector current. So IC in terms of this is equal to IS e to the power of the instantaneous voltage, that is small V, capital VE divided by VT. So which is written as IS equal to e to the power of, just I have written VBE plus VBE, VBE plus small VE. So this is DC, this is small signal voltage. Okay. So now I will just see e to the power of A plus B is nothing but e to the power of A into e to the power of B. You can observe I written e to the power of VBE by VT into e to the power of VBE by VT, which is equal to, now just see, now this fellow, is nothing but same as the equation, diode equation, what I have taken, I have written IC, which is equal to e to the power of small vb by vt. Okay, so now this particular fellow vbe, small vb is a small signal, which is very small signal. I am considering it is smaller than vt. As soon as I am doing this, I am performing small signal approximation. Small signal approximation, which is done using exponential series expansion, where e to the power of x for limited for two terms, I have write it as 1 plus x, where x is nothing but vp by vt. I have written here ic multiplied with 1 plus x vp divided by vt. This is called as exponential series expansion. Exponential series expansion. Now this particular condition is true only when the small signal voltage which is superimposed is maintained as less than 10 millivolts. Less than 10 millivolts. Now let's see in the next step. IC plus IC into VB by VT. I have got this particular equation. As I have written VB for the voltage equation, I'll write IC. I capital C is equal to capital I capital C plus small I small c. Now if I compare these two equations, I will tell this instantaneous collector current equation producing small signal current, which is small signal current IC is equal to IC by VT into VB. Now you just see what is the definition of resistance. Resistance is V by R. Now inverse of that is I by V. Now I by V means it is going to be called as transconductance. It is the definition of transconductance, which is denoted as GM multiplied with small signal VB. Now you see the current equation, what I have got amplified version, is having GM multiplied with VB. So this amplifier is called as a transconductance amplifier. At the same time, I have got output is current, input I have obtained as small VB. Okay, the same thing if I am trying to explain in a graphical mode, I am going to plot graph with instantaneous collector current versus instantaneous base emitter voltage. So plot is when VB slowly increases, so suddenly at some point after some VBE there is sharp increase in the collector current. That means I am going to say that it is an amplified version of small signal analysis. Now just see in the input side, I am passing small signal, that is VBE, that is triangular, I am considering triangle wave VBE, which is measured at a verified point Q point, where DC biasing current, collector current is passed. Now as soon as it is superimposed, it is operated in active mode. Amplified version of collector current, small signal collector current is obtained. You can observe the small triangle wave, you have got an enlarged triangle wave. If suppose I am trying to find its slope, I am going to find a slope opposite by adjacent. Opposite is current, adjacent is voltage. So that is IC by VB, which is nothing but definition of transconductance. Hence, it proves that this graph proves that the small signal operation going to produce you amplified version of small signal collector current, and it is an example of transconductance amplifier. Therefore, I have obtained transconductance equation GM, which is equal to IC by VT, So I am also called as GM is equal to small IC by small VB, right? So I hope you have understood everything in this particular concept. The first model what we have studied is collector current and transconductance. In the next session, we will discuss base current with its input resistance, emitter current and its input resistance. Thank you.